Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Bristol Theatre Program's production of Romeo and Juliet. I am David Ledoux. I'm the director of the program here, but I'm not the director of this production. The director of this production is a wonderful, wonderful guest director named Brien Lang, and he's done a wonderful job with our students. It's just been a really great process to see them grow and work. And it's been so lovely to be coming back out of the pandemic, good to be with you. We are still at half capacity crowds here, so we only have 30 tickets that we're selling, but we are live streaming to the world. So we're on YouTube right now, to the world. Those of you who might be watching at home, like and subscribe, and you guys can like and subscribe as well. There's a digital program in the description. And there's also a place to donate. If you want to donate to us and support our students, support our theater program, then you can click on that and do that as well. And when you all are watching at home, when you want to see the production later, you can do the same thing. So we have such an array of students here. We have some theater majors, some non-majors, some students who started when they were nothing but a little Zoom square during the pandemic. Some started before the pandemic, some started and then graduated and then came back. So we have a large array of students, and some are doing their first show ever. This will be like their first performance, their second performance ever. So you get to be the warm, inviting, lovely audience that gets to welcome them into this great thing called theater that we do here. Next up, if you want to be a part of the action, we are doing Pippin. So come out and audition for Pippin. That's going to be Tuesday and Wednesday. And the production will be in the big theater over across the hall. And then after that, we're going to be doing Our Town. And we're doing Our Town in our new Taunton space. So we're going to be christening that space with a nice American classic. And we were doing Our Town. We were 3 weeks in when the pandemic started. So we're not going to let the virus win. Yeah. We're back. And we're going to do Our Town. Okay, that's all I got. Please turn off cell phones. No unwrapping candy or making noise. You're in a theater, for goodness sake. And enjoy the show.
To them if they bear it. to bite my thumb, sir.
Do you bite your thumb at us, sir?
Is the law of our side if I say I?
No.
No, sir, I do not bite my thumb at you, sir. But I do bite my thumb, sir.
You quarrel, sir? Quarrel, sir. No, sir.
If you do, sir, I am for you. I serve as good a man as you.
No better.
Well, sir?
Say better. Here comes one of my master's kingmen.
Yes, better, sir.
You lie.
Draw if you be men. Gregory, remember thy swashing blow.
Your swords, you don't know what you do.
What? Drawn among these heartless hinds? Turn thee, Mercutio. Look upon thy death.
I do but keep the peace. Put up thy sword or manage to part these men with me.
What? Drawn and talk of peace? I hate the word, as I hate hell, all Montagues, and thee. Have at thee, coward.
Get him, Mercutio!
Yes.
Mercutio!
Come down, Tybalt!
Rebellious subjects, enemies to the peace, profanes of our saints' healing. Will they not hear? Woohoo, you man, you beast! Throw your mistempered weapons to the ground, and hear the sounds of removed prince! Three civil brawls, iron and fair war between all Catholic and Montague, have disturbed the quiet of our streets. If you ever disturb our streets again, your life shall pay forfeit on the pain of death. All men depart!
Oh, where is Romeo? Saw you him today?
Right glad I am he was not at this fray.
See where he comes. Good morrow, cousin.
Is the day so young?
But new struck nine.
Ay, me. Sad hours seem long.
What sadness lengthens Romeo's hours?
Not having that which having makes them short.
In love?
Out.
Of love?
Out of her favor where I am in love.
Alas, love so gentle in his view should be so tyrannous and rough in proof.
This love feel I, that feel no love in this. Dost thou not laugh?
Oh man, cause I'd rather weep.
Good heart at what?
At thy good heart's oppression.
Why, such is love's transgression.
So tell me in sadness, who is that you love?
In sadness, cousin, I do love a woman.
I am so near when I suppose that you loved.
A right fair mark, man, and she's fair I love.
A right fair mark, fair cause, as soon as hit.
Well, in that hit you miss. She'll not be hit with Cupid's arrow. Oh, she is rich in beauty, only poor, that when she dies with beauty, dies her store.
And she has sworn that she will still live chaste?
She hath, and in that sparing makes huge waste. For beauty starred with her severity cuts beauty off from all posterity.
Be ruled by me, forget to think of her.
Oh, teach me how I should forget to think.
By giving liberty unto thine eyes, examine other beauties.
Show me a mistress passing fair. What doth her beauty serve but as a note where I may read who pass that passing fair? Farewell. Thou canst not teach me to forget.
I'll pay that doctrine, or else die in debt.
Go, sirrah, tread your bow. Through fair Verona find those persons out whose names are written there. And to them say, my house, and welcome on their pleasure stay.
Find them out whose names are written here. I can never find the names the writing person hath herein, for I cannot read.
Nor I.
We must till I learn it.
Tut, man, one fire burns out, another's burning. Take thou some new infection to thy eye, and the rank and poison of the old will die.
Good end, good fellow.
God ye, good end. I pray you, sir, can you read?
Aye, mine own fortune and my misery.
Perhaps you have learned it without book, but I pray, can you read anything you see?
Aye, if I know the letters and the language.
You say honestly. Rest you merry.
Stay, fellows, I can read. Signor Martino and his wife and daughters, County Anselmi and his beauteous sisters, Signor Placentio and his lovely nieces, Mercutio and his brother Valentine. Mine uncle Capulet, his wife and daughters. My fair niece, Rosalie. A fair assembly, whither should they come? Whither?
To supper to our house.
Whose house?
Our master's.
Indeed, I should have asked you that before.
Now I'll tell you without asking, my master is the great rich Capulet. But if you're not a Montague, then come crush a couple of mine. Rest, you merry.
And at the same ancient feast of the Capulets,
sups the fair Rosaline thou so lovest,
and all the admired beauties of Verona.
Go thither, and with untainted eye, compare her face to some that I shall show. And I'll make thee think thy swan a crow.
Caw, caw, caw!
I'll go along, no such sight to be shown, but to rejoice in splendor of mine own. Mercutio!
Nurse? Nurse? Where's my daughter? Call her forth to me.
Oh, by my life, where's this girl? What, Juliet?
How now, who calls?
Your mother!
Madam, I'm here. What is your will?
This is the matter. Nurse, give leave a while. We must talk in secret. Nurse, come back again. I have remembered me thou's hear our counsel. Thou knowest my daughter is of a pretty age.
Faith, I can tell her age unto an hour. Nay, I do bear a brain, but as I said, I do recall the day she broke her brow, and then my husband, oh God be with his soul, he was a merry man, took up the child. Yeah, quoth my husband, dost thou fall upon thy face? Thou wilt fall backward when thou hast more wit, wilt thou not, Jewel? And by my holidame, the pretty wretch left crying, and said I, to see now how a jest shall come about. I warrant, and I shall live a thousand years. I never should forget it. Wilt thou not, Jewel? The pretty fool it did to that said I.
Enough of this. I pray thee, hold thy peace.
Yes, madam.
Now, Juliet.
Yet I cannot choose but laugh, to think it should leave crying and say I'll. Yeah, quoth my husband, false upon thy face. Thou wilt fall backward when thou comest to age. Wilt thou not, Jewel? Instinct, and said I.
Instinct, thou too, I pray thee. Nurse, say I.
Peace, peace, I have done.
Tell me, daughter.
God mark thee to his grace. Thou was the prettiest maid that I e'er saw. And I might live to see thee married once, I have my wish.
Mary, that marries the very theme I came to talk of. Tell me, daughter Juliet, how stands your disposition to be married?
It's an honor that I dream not of.
Well, think of marriage now, younger than you. Here in Verona, ladies of esteem are made already mothers. By my account, I was your mother much upon these years that you are now a maid. Thus, then in brief, the valiant Paris seeks you for his love.
A man, young lady! Lady, such a man! As all the world, why, he's a man of wax.
Verona's summer hath not such a flower.
Nay, he's a flower, in faith, a very flower.
What say you? Can you love the gentleman? Speak briefly. Can you like a Paris's love?
I'll look to like, if looking like a move.
Madam! The guests have come. Supper served up. You called? She asked for the nurse crushed in the pantry. I beseech you. Follow straight.
We follow thee.
Go, girl! Seek happy nights to happy days!
Give me a torch. I am not for this ambling. Being but heavy, I will bear the light.
Nay, gentle Romeo, must have you dance.
Oh, not I, believe me. You have dancing shoes with nimble soles. I have a soul filled with lead, which so stakes me to the ground I cannot move.
You are a lover. Pour out Cupid's wings and soar with them above the common bound.
I am to soar and pierce with his shaft, to soar with his light feathers. Under love's heavy burden, I do sink.
And to sink in it, should you burden love to create oppression for a tender thing?
Is love a tender thing? It is too rough, too rude, too boisterous, and it pricks like thorn.
If love be rough with you, be rough with love. Prick love for pricking, and you beat love down. Give me a case to put my visage in. A visor for a visor?
And we mean well in going to this mask, but 'tis no wit to go.
Why, may I ask?
I dreamed a dream tonight.
And so did I.
Well, what was yours?
That dreamers often lie.
And you better sleep while they do dream things true.
Oh, I see Queen Mab have been with you.
She's the fairy's midwife, and she comes in a shape no bigger than agate stone. On the forefinger of an alderman, drawn by a team of little atomies, a swart man's nose is a liaison, her wagon spokes made of long spider's legs, the cover of the wings of grasshopper, her whip of cricket's bone, the lash of film, her wagoner is a small gray-coated gnat. Her chariot is nothing but empty hazelnut, and in this state she gallops night by night through lovers' brains, and then they dream of love. Over courteous knees that dream on curtsy straight, over lawyer's fingers that straight dream on fees, over lady's lips that straight on kisses dream. Sometimes she driveth over soldier's neck, then he dream of cutting foreign throats. Of breeches and moscatos and Spanish blades! This be the
peace, peace, Mercutio, peace! Thou talks of nothing.
True, I talk of dreams, which are the children of idle brain, begot of nothing but vain fantasy, which is as thin of substance as the air, and as inconsistent as the wind. This wind you speak of blows us from ourselves. Supper is done, we shall arrive too late.
I fear too early, for my mind misgives some consequence yet hanging in the stars. I fear some vile forfeit of untimely death. But he that hath the steerage of my course, direct my sail, on, lusty gentlemen!
Strike from!
Welcome, gentlemen, my mistresses. Which of you all will now deny to dance? You are welcome. Come, musicians, play.
Doth embrace the hand of yonder knight. Oh, she doth teach the torches to burn bright. Did my heart love till now? Forswear its sight, for I ne'er saw true beauty till this night.
This by his voice should be a Montague. Now, by the stock and honor of my king, strike him dead, I hold it not a sin.
Why, how now, kinsman? Wherefore storm you so?
Madame, this is a Montague, our foe. A villain that is hither come in spite to scorn at our solemnity this night.
Young Romeo, is it?
'Tis he, a villain Romeo.
Content thee, gentle cause, let him alone. To say truth, all of Verona brags of him to be a virtuous and well-governed youth. I would not for the wealth of all the town here in my house do him disparagement.
I'll not endure him.
He shall be endured. What goodman boy, I say he shall.
Madam, 'tis a shame.
Go to.
But if he's...
Am I the master here or you?
But
go to.
I'll not endure him.
You'll not endure him? God shall mend my soul. You'll make a mutiny among my guests.
'Tis a shame.
Go to. Go to. You are a saucy boy, so indeed. Be quiet. More light. For shame, I'll make you quiet. But cheerly, my heart.
This intrusion, now seeming sweet, shall convert to bitter gall.
If I profane with my unworthiest hand this holy shrine, the gentle fine as this, my lips to wishing pilgrims ready stand to smooth that rough touch, the tender kiss.
Good pilgrim,
wrong. You do wrong your hand too much, which mainly devotion shows in this. For saints have hands that lovers' hands do touch, and palm to palm this holy palmer's kiss.
Oh, then, dear saint, let lips do what hands do.
Saints do not move without grant for prayer's sake.
Then move not while my prayer's effect I take. Thus, by my lips from yours, my sin is purged.
Then have my lips the sin that they have took.
Sin to my lips? Oh, trespass, sweetly earned.
Is my son?
Madam! Your mother craves a word with you.
What is her mother?
Mary Bachelor. Her mother is the lady of the house.
Is she a Capulet? Oh, dear account, my life is my foe's debt. Boy, be gone, the sport is at its best. Aye, so I fear the more is my unrest.
Come hither, nurse. What's yon gentleman?
I know not.
Go ask his name. If he be married, my grave is like to be my wedding bed.
What's yon name of yon gentleman? Perhaps. Ah, Romeo. Hey, one. Ah. His name is Romeo and a Montague, the only son of your great enemy.
My only love sprung from my only hate. Too early seeing unknown and known too late. Prodigious birth of love it is to me that I must love a loathed enemy.
What's this?
A rhyme I learn, even now, the one I dance with all. Juliet!
Anon, anon! Come, let's away, the strangers are all gone.
Can I go forward when my heart is here? Turn back, dull earth, and find thy center out.
Romeo!
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 Tears, madman, passion, lover. Appear thou in likeness of a sigh. Speak but one rhyme, and I shall be satisfied. Cry but Amy, pronounced but love and dove. I conjure thee by Rosaline's bright eyes. By her fine foot, her straight leg, and her quivering thigh. He speaks not. He stirreth not. Romeo, keep night out in my truckle bed. 'Tis all in vain to seek him here by means that shall not be found.
He jests at scars that never felt a wound.
What's up? What light through yonder window breaks?
It is the east, and Juliet is the sun. Arise, fair sun, and kill that envious moon. It is my lady, oh, it is my love. Oh, that she knew she were. She speaks, yet she says nothing. What of that? Oh, see how she leans her cheek upon her hand. Oh, that I were a glove upon that hand, that I might touch that cheek.
Hi, me.
She speaks. Oh, speak again, bright angel.
Oh, Romeo, Romeo, wherefore art thy Romeo? Deny thy father and refuse thy name. Or if thou wilt not, well, be sworn, my love, and thou no longer be a Capulet.
Shall I hear more, or shall I speak at this?
'Tis but thy name that is my enemy. Art thou self not a Montague? What's a Montague? It is nor hand, nor foot, nor arm, nor face, nor any other part belonging to a man. Oh, be some other name. What's in a name? That which we call a rose by name, a name would smell as sweet. Romeo, doff thy name, and for that name that is no part of thee, take all of myself.
I take thee at thy word. Call me but love, and I'll be new baptized. Henceforth, I never will be Romeo.
What man art thou than the screened knight, so stumblest on my counsel?
By a name, I know not how to tell thee who I am. My name, dear saint, is hateful to myself because it is an enemy to thee. Had I it written, I would tear the word.
Art thou not Romeo and a Montague?
Neither, fair saint, if either thee dislike.
How camest thou hither? Tell me, and wherefore? The orchard walls are high and hard to climb, and the place death, considering who thou art, if any of my kinsmen find thee here.
With love's light wings did I o'erperch these walls, for stony limits cannot hold love out.
If they see thee, they will murder thee.
Alack, there lies more peril in thine eyes than 20 of their swords.
I would not for the world have them see here.
I have night's cloak to hide me from their sight.
Dost thou know the mask of night is on my face? Or else it may in blush bepaint my cheek? For thou thus hast heard me speak tonight. Dost thou love me? I know that will say aye, and I will take thy word, but if thou swearest, they mayest prove false. O gentle Romeo, if thou dost love, pronounce it faithfully.
Lady, by yonder blessed moon, I swear the silver tips with all these fruit tree tops.
Oh, swear not by the moon, the inconstant moon, that monthly changes in her circled orb, lest that love prove likewise variable.
What shall I swear by?
Well, do not swear at all. Or, if thou wilt, swear by the gracious self.
If my heart's dear love...
Do not swear, although I joy in thee. I have no joy of this contract tonight. It is too rash, too unadvised, too sudden. Sweet good night.
Oh, wilt thou leave me so unsatisfied?
What satisfaction canst thou have tonight?
The exchange of thy love's faithful vow for mine.
I gave thee mine when thou didst request it. I'm worried if it was given again.
Lady Juliet!
I hear some noise within. Dear love, adieu. Ananda, nurse, sweet Montague. Stay but a little. I'll come again.
Oh, blessed, blessed night. I am afeard, being in night, all this is but a dream.
Dear words, dear Romeo, and good night indeed. If that thy love be honorable, thy purpose marriage, send me word tomorrow, I'll prepare to come to thee. And all my fortunes at thy foot I lay, and follow thee, my lord, throughout the world.
Madam!
I come anon. But thou meanest not well, I do beseech thee.
Madam!
By and by I come! To seize thy suit and lead me to my grave tomorrow I send.
Oh, so thrive my soul in
a thousand times good night.
A thousand times the worse to want thy light.
Romeo. Oh, for Faulkner's voice. Romeo!
My dear?
I forgot why I called thee back.
Let me stand here till thou remember it.
I shall forget to still have thee still stand there.
And I'll still stand here to have thee still forget.
'Tis almost morning, I would have thee gone. Good night. Good night. Parting is such sweet sorrow that I shall say good night to thee, Mara.
Sleep well upon thine eyes. Peace in thy breast. Oh, would I were sleep and peace so sweet to rest. Thus will I to my ghostly father sell his help to crave and my dear hap to tell.
In the infant bride, this small flower, poison, hath resonance, and medicine power. For this, being smelt, with that part cheers each part. Being tasted, slays all senses with the heart. Two such opposed things encamp them still in man, as well as herbs, grace, and rude will. And, for the worser is predominant, full soon the canker death eats up that plant.
Good morrow, father.
What a decent day! What early tongue so sweet salute me? Come, son, it argues a distempered head. So soon to bid good morrow to thy bed. for. If not so, then here I had right. Our Romeo hath not been in bed tonight.
The last is true, the sweeter rest was mine.
God pardon sin. Was thou with Rosaline?
With Rosaline? My ghostly father, no. I forgot that name, and that name's woe.
That's my good son. Where hast thou been then?
I'll tell thee ere thou ask it me again. I have been feasting with mine enemy, whereupon a sudden one hath wounded me. Thus by me wounded, both our remedies within thy help and holy physic lies.
Be plain, good son, and homely in thy drift.
Then plainly know that my heart's dear love is set on the fair daughter of rich Capulet. I'll tell thee as we pass, but this I pray that thou consent to marry us today.
Oh, it's St. Francis! What a change is here! It's Rosaline, whom thou didst love so dear, so soon forsaken? Young men's love then lies, not truly in their hearts, but in their eyes.
Thou chidest me off for loving Rosaline.
For doting, not for loving, people mine.
When bad is me, bury love.
Not in a grave, to lay one in, another out to have.
I pray thee, father, chide not, for she whom I love now doth grace for grace and love for love allow. The other did not so.
Oh, she knew well. Thy love did read by rote and could not spell. But come, young waverer, come with me. In one respect, I'll thy assistant be. For this alliance may so happy prove to turn your household's rancor to pure love.
Oh, let us hence. I stand on sudden haste.
Wisely and slow, they stumble that run fast.
Signor Romeo, bonjour.
You gave us the counterfeit fairly last night.
Good morrow. What counterfeit did I give you?
Oh, the slips of the slip. Can you not conceive?
Oh, pardon, good Mercutio. My business was great, and in such a case, a man may strain courtesy.
Oh, as much to say, a case such as yours strains a mind of bow in the hand.
Meaning to curtsy.
That's most kindly, is it?
A most courteous exposition.
Oh, why now is this not better than a groaning for love? Now art thou
sociable.
Now art thou Romeo. Now art thou what thou art as well as by nature.
But here's goodly gear.
A sail, a sail.
Gregory. God ye good morrow, gentlemen.
God ye good den, gentlewoman.
It is a good den.
Ah, yes. Tis no less. The body hand of the dial is upon the prick of noon.
Out upon you, what a man are you?
One gentlewoman that God hath made himself to mar.
By my troth, it is well said for himself to mar. Gentlemen, can any of you tell me where I might find the young Romeo?
I can tell you, but young Romeo will be older when you have found him than when you sought him. I am the youngest of that name.
For fault of a worse.
You say well.
Yes, the worst well. Very well took, I faith. Wisely, wisely.
If you do be he, sir, I desire some confidence with you.
I will follow you.
Oh, farewell, ancient lady, farewell.
And a merry farewell to you. I pray you, sir, what saucy merchant was this that was so full of his ropery?
A gentleman, nurse. One who loves to hear himself talk and will speak more in a minute than he will stand to in a month.
And if speak anything against me, I'll take him down. And I will lustier than he is, and 20 such jacks. I pray you, sir, a word. As I told you, my young lady bid me inquire you out. But first, let me tell ye, if ye should lead her into a fool's paradise, as they say, to a very gross kind of behavior, as they say. For the gentlewoman is young, and therefore, if you should deal double with
her. Nurse, nurse, commend me to thy lady and mistress, I protest unto thee.
Good heart and I faith. I'll tell her as much. Oh, Lord, she'll be a joyful woman.
Bid her devise some means to come to church this afternoon, and there she shall at Friar Lawrence's be shrived and married. Here is for thy pains.
Oh, truly, sir, not a penny.
Go to, I say you shall.
This afternoon, sir? Well, she shall be there.
Farewell, commend me to thy mistress.
Ah, yes, God heaven bless thee. Hark you, sir.
Commend me to thy lady.
Ah, yes, a thousand times.
The clock struck 9 when I did send the nurse. In half an hour she promised to return. Oh, she is lame. Had she affections and warm youthful blood, she'd be as swift as motion as a ball, but old folks many feign unwieldily slow, heavy as oh God, she comes. Oh, honey nurse, what news? Has thou met with him? Send thy man away.
Gregory, stay at the gate.
Now, nurse, oh God, why dost thou look sad? Thy news be sad, yet tell it merrily.
I am aweary, give me leave a while. Fie, how my bones ache! Ooh, what a jaunt have I had!
I wish thou had my bones and I thy news. Nay, come, I pray thee, speak. Good nurse, speak.
Jesu, what haste! Can you not stay a while? Can you not see that I am out of breath?
How art thou out of breath? When thou hast breath, to tell me thou art out of breath, is thy news good or bad? Answer to that.
Well, you have made a simple choice. You know not how to choose a man. Romeo, no, not he. Though his face be better than any man's, and his leg excels all men's. He's not the flower of courtesy that...
What says he of our marriage? What of that?
Ooh, my head! Ooh, what a head have I! It beats as it would fall in 20 pieces. Ooh, my back! Ooh, the other side. Ooh, my back! My back! Be sure your heart for sending me about to catch my death with jaunting up and down.
My faith, I am sorry thou art not well. Sweet, sweet nurse. Tell me, what says my love?
Your love says, like an honest gentleman, and a courteous, and a kind, and a handsome, and I warrant a virtuous. Where is your mother?
Where is my mother? Why, she is within. How oddly thou repliest. Your love says, like an honest gentleman, where is your mother?
God's lady, dear, are you so hot? Is this the poultice for my aching bones? Henceforward, do your messages yourself.
Here's such a coil. Tell me, what says Romeo?
Have you got leave to go to church today?
I have.
Then hie you hence to Friar Lawrence's cell. There stays a husband to make your wife. Ah, now comes the wanton blood up in your cheeks. Go, hie you to the cell.
Hie the high fortune, honest nurse, farewell.
So smile the heavens upon this holy act that hours after sorrow shines not.
Amen, amen. But come what sorrow can, do thou but close our hands with holy words, then love devouring death do what he dare. This is enough for me, but call her mine.
These violent delights have violent ends, and in their triumph die. Therefore, love moderately, and long doth so. Too swift arrives just as tardy as too slow. Here comes the lady. Oh, so light of foot will ne'er wear out the everlasting flint.
Good evening to my ghostly confessor.
Come with me. And we shall make short tour. For by her leaves, you two shall not stay alone till fully church incorporate 2 and 1.
Follow me close. I'll speak to them. Gentlemen, good den. A word with one of you.
And a word with one of us. Couple with something. Make it a word and a blow.
Shall find me apt enough to that, sir.
And you'll give me occasion.
Could you not take an occasion without giving? Mercutio, thou consort is
Romeo. Consort? What dost thou make us, minstrels? And thou make us minstrels shall hear nothing but discords. Here's my fiddlestick. Here's that shall make you dance. Zooms, consort.
Peace be with you, sir. Here comes my man.
I'll be hanged, sir, if you wear your livery.
Romeo, the hate I bear for thee can afford no better term than this. Thou art a villain.
Tybalt, the reason that I have to love you doth much excuse the appertaining rage to such a greeting. Villain am I not. Therefore, farewell. I see thou knowest me not.
Boy, this shall not excuse the injuries that thou hast done me. Therefore, turn and draw.
I do protest I never injured thee, but love thee better than thou canst devise, till thou shalt know the reason of my love. And so, good Capulet, which name I tender as dearly as my own, be satisfied.
Oh, calm, dishonorable, vile submission! Tybalt, you rat catcher, will you walk?
But what dost thou have with me?
Your king of cats, nothing but one of your nine lives.
I am for you.
Gentle Mercutio, put thy rapier up!
Come, sir, you bastardo!
Gentlemen, for shame! Forbear this outrage! The prince expressly hath forbidden bandying Verona's streets!
Hold, Tybalt!
Oh, God, Mercutio!
I'm hurt! Plugging up both your houses! I'm sped! Is he left and hath nothing?
What, art thou hurt?
Aye, aye, it's just a scratch. And it's just enough.
Courage, man, the hurt cannot be much.
Not to so deep as a well, nor as wise a chest to my much will serve. Come tomorrow, you shall find me a very grave man. Oh, plague on both your houses. Why, the devil came in between us. Who's hurt under your arm?
I thought all for the best.
Play up both your houses. It made worms meet at me. I shall have you too, and your houses.
He's gone.
This gentleman, the prince's near ally, my very friend, hath got his mortal hurt in my behalf. My reputation stained with Tybalt's slander. Tybalt, that an hour hath been my kinsman. Oh, Juliet, thy affections hath made me effeminate, and in my temper softened fouler steel. Alive, in triumph, and Mercutio slain. Now, Tybalt, take the villain back again that late thou gavest me, for Mercutio's soul is but a little way above our heads, staying for thine to keep him company. Either thou, or I, or both must go with him.
Thou wretched boy, thou didst consort him here. It shalt with him hence.
This shall determine that.
Romeo! Romeo, where have you gone?
Oh, I am fortune's fool.
Begins of this fray.
There lies a man, Giuseppe again, Romeo. They see the keys man, brave Mercutio. They both here, with Romeo's hand to slay.
And for that offense, we do exile him hence. Let Romeo hence haste out, and when he's found, that moment's his last.
Gallop of pace, you fiery foot steeds. Spread thy close curtains, love performing night. Come night, come Romeo, come day and night, come gentle night, come loving black brown night. Give me my Romeo, and when he shall die, take him and cut him out in little stars, and he shall make the heavens of earth so fine that all the world would be in love with thy knight and pay no worship to the garish sun. Oh, here comes my nurse, and she brings news. What hast thou there? The cords that Romeo bid thee fetch?
Aye, the cords.
Now, nurse, what news? Why dost thou wring thy hands?
Well-a-day, he's dead! We are undone, lady, we are undone!
Can heaven be so envious?
Romeo can, no, heaven cannot. Oh, Romeo, whoever would have thought it, Romeo!
What devil art thou that must torment me thus? Has Romeo slain himself?
I saw the mark in my own eyes. God save the mark here on his manly breast.
Oh, break my heart, or bankrupt, break at once.
Oh, Tybalt, the best friend I ever had. Courteous Tybalt, honest gentleman, that I should have lived to see thee dead.
What storm that blows so contrary? Is Romeo slighted and is Tybalt dead? My dear loved cousin and my dear lord?
Tybalt is gone, and Romeo banished. Romeo that slew Tybalt, he is banished!
Oh God, did Romeo's hand shed Tybalt's blood?
It did, alas the day it did.
Did ever dragon keep so fair a cave? Beautiful tyrant, fiend, angelical, oh, the deceased should dwell in such a gorgeous palace.
There is no trust, no faith, no honesty in men. Oh, these griefs, these woes, these sorrows, they make me old. Shame come to Romeo!
Blistered be thy tongue for such a wish! Oh, what beast was I to chide at him?
Would you speak well of he that killed your cousin?
Shall I speak ill of him that is my husband? Lord, what tongue shall smooth thy name, when I, thy 3 hours' wife, have mangled it? But wherefore, villain, didst thou kill my cousin? That villain cousin would I killed my husband. Back, foolish tears, back to your knave spring. My husband lives that Tybalt would have slain, and Tybalt's dead that would have slain my husband. All this comfort, yet I weep then. Tybalt is dead, and Romeo is banished. Banished, that one word banished has slain 10,000 Tybalts. Romeo is banished. To speak that name is mother Tybalt, Romeo, Juliet, all slain, all dead. Where's my mother, nurse?
Weeping and wailing over Tybalt's corpse. Will you go to her? I will bring you thither.
Wash they his wounds with tears? Mine shall be spent when there's a dry for Romeo's banishment. Take up those ropes, poor cords you are beguiled, both you and I, for Romeo's exile. Come, cords, come, nurse, both you and I to my wedding bed, and death, not Romeo, take my maidenhead.
Hide you to a chamber! I'll find Romeo to comfort you. I know well where he is.
Oh, give this ring to my true knight. I bid him to take his last farewell.
Romeo, come forth, thou fearful man. Affliction is enamored of thy parts, and thou art wedded to calamity.
Father, what news?
I bring thee tidings of the prince's doom.
What less than doomsday is the prince's doom?
A gentler judgment banished from his lips.
Not body's death, but body's banishment.
Ha! Banishment! Be merciful, say death, do not say banishment.
Hence from Verona art thou banished. Be patient, for the world is broad and wide.
There is no world without Verona walls, but purgatory, torture, hell itself.
A deadly sin, a rude unthankfulness. This is dear mercy, and thou seest it not.
'Tis torture and not mercy. Heaven is here where Juliet lives, and every cat and dog, little mouse, every unworthy thing live here in heaven and may look on her. But Romeo may not.
Flies may do this, but from this I must fly, and sayest thou yet that exile is not death? Hast thou no poison mix, no sharp ground knife, no sudden mean of death, though ne'er so mean, but banish it to kill me? Banish it! Oh, friar, the damned use that word in hell.
Thou fond madman, hear me, but speak a word.
Oh, thou wilt speak again of banishment.
I'll give thee comfort to keep off that word. Adversity's sweet milk, philosophy, to comfort thee, though thou art banished.
And yet banish it. Hang up philosophy, it helps not, it prevails not. Talk no more.
How? Then I see that madmen have no ears.
How should they when that wise men have no eyes?
Let me dispute with thee of thy state.
Thou canst not speak of that thou dost not feel. Wert thou as young as I, Juliet thy love, Tybalt murdered, doting like me, and like me banished, then mightst thou speak. Then mightst thou tear thy hair and fall upon the ground as I do, taking the measure of an unmade grave.
Arise. One knocks. Come, Romeo, hide thyself. Hark, how they knock. Whence come you? What's your will?
Let me in, and you shall know my errand. I come from Lady Juliet.
Welcome, then.
Oh, holy friar! Oh, tell me, holy friar, where is my lady's lord? Where's Romeo?
There, on the ground, with his own tears made drunk.
Oh, he is so even in my mistress's case. Even so lies she, blubbering and weeping, weeping and blubbering. Stand up! Stand up! Stand and you be a man, for Juliet's sake!
Nurse! Speakest thou, Juliet? How is it with her?
Oh, she says nothing, sir, but weeps and weeps. And now falls on her bed and then starts up. And Tybalt calls, and then on Romeo cries. And then down falls again.
Oh, friar, tell me in what vile part of this anatomy does my name lodge? Tell me that I may sack the hateful mansion!
Hold thy desperate hip. Thou hast amazed me. By my holy order, I thought thy disposition better tempered. Hast thou slain Tybalt? Will thou slay thyself? And slay thy lady too that lives within thee by doing it damn and hate upon thyself. What? Where I was leaving, thy Juliet is alive. There art thou happy. Tybalt would have killed thee. Thou slewest Tybalt, there art thou happy too. The law that threatened death becomes thy friend, turns it to exile. There art thou happy. A pack of blessings lights upon thy bed. Go, get thee to thy love. Ascend her chamber, hence, and comfort her. But look thou, stay not till the watch be set, for then thou canst not pass to Mantua, for thou shalt live till we can find time lays your marriage, reconcile your friends, beg pardon of the prince, and call thee back. Go before, nurse, commend me to thy lady, and bid her hasten all the house to bed.
Oh, Lord, I could have stayed here all the night to hear good counsel of what learning is. My lord, I'll tell my lady you will come. Here, sir, a ring she bid me give you, sir. Hie you, make haste, for it grows very late.
Oh, how well my comfort is revived by this.
Go forth, go hence, and here stands all your state. By the break of day, be gone from hence.
Will thou be gone? It was the nightingale, not the lark, that pierced the fearful hollow at thy ear.
It was the lark, the herald of the morn, no nightingale. Look, love, what envious streaks do lace the clouds in yonder east. Night's candles are burnt out.
Young light is not daylight, I know it. If we stay yet, me is not to be gone.
Let me be tamed. Let me be put to death. I am content, so thou wilt have it so. How is my soul? Let's talk, it is not day.
It is. pants, be gone, away. It was the lark that sang so out of tune. Be gone, away. More light and light grows.
More light and light, more dark and dark our woes.
Madam!
Nurse?
Your lady mother is coming to your chamber. The day is broke, be wary, look about.
Then window let day in and let light out.
Farewell. One kiss and I'll descend.
Art thou gone so? Love, Lord, I, husband, friend, I shall hear from thee in every hour of every day, for in every hour there are much in days. Oh, by this count much in years, then I begin to behold my Romeo again.
I will omit no opportunity that may convey my greetings, love, to thee.
Dost thou think we'll ever meet again?
I doubt it not, and all these woes shall serve as sweet discourses in our time to come.
Oh, I have an ill-divining soul. Methinks I see thee now thou art below, as one in a tomb. Either my eyesight fails, or thou lookest pale.
Trust me, love, in my eyes so do you. And dry sorrow drinks our blood. Adieu, adieu!
How, daughter, are you up? Why, how now, Juliet?
I am not well.
Evermore weeping for your cousin's death. What, wilt thou wash him from his grave with tears?
Yet let me weep for such a feeling was.
Well, thou weepest not so much for his death as if the villain lives which slaughtered him.
What villain, pray?
That same villain, Romeo. But now I'll tell thee joyful tidings, girl.
In happy time? What day is that, I beseech you?
Well, to put thee from thy heaviness, we have sorted out a sudden day of joy that thou expectest not, nor I look not for.
A day of joy? What is that?
Mary, my child, early next Thursday morn, the gallant, young, and noble gentleman in the county Paris at St. Peter's Church shall happily make thee there a joyful bride.
Now by St. Peter's Church and Peter too? He shall not make me there a joyful bride. I wonder at this haste that I must wed. I will not marry yet. And when I do, I promise you, it shall be Romeo, whom you know I hate, rather than Paris.
Are you so proud that you'd refuse what we have wrought? So worthy a gentleman to be your bridegroom.
Not proud you have, but thankful that you have. Proud can I never be of what I hate, but even for hate that is meant love.
How now, chop logic, what is this? Proud, and I thank you, and I thank you not? Thank me no thankings, nor crown me nor proud, but feather your fine joints against Thursday next to go with Paris to St. Peter's Church, or I will drag thee there on a hurdle thither.
I beseech you on my knees, hear me with patience, but to speak a word.
Hang thee, young baggage, disobedient wretch. I'll tell thee what, get thee to church on Thursday, or never after look me in the face. Speak not, reply not, do not answer me.
God in heaven, bless her. You are to blame, madame, to rage her so.
And why, my lady wisdom, hold your tongue.
I speak no treason.
Oh God, ye God.
May not one speak.
Peace, you mumbling fool. God's bread, it makes me mad. And you be mine, I'll give you to my friend. And you be not, hang, beg, starve, die in the streets. For by my soul I'll ne'er acknowledge thee, nor what is mine shall never do thee good. Trust you to be, think you, I'll not be forsworn.
Oh God, oh nurse, how shall this be prevented? My husband is on earth, my faith in heaven. Some comfort, nurse?
Faith, here it is. Romeo has perished and all the world to nothing. He dares never come back to challenge you. Or if he do, it needs must be by stealth. And since the case so stands as now it doth, I think it best you married with the county. He's a lovely gentleman. Romeo's a dish cup to him.
Thou speakest from thy heart?
And from my soul, too, or else beshrew them both.
Amen.
What?
Well, thou hast come for me marvelous much. Go in, and tell my lady I am to Friar Lawrence's cell to be absolved and make confession.
Mary, I will, and this is wisely done.
Ancient damnation, oh, most wicked fiend! Me and my bosom henceforth shall be twain. Am I to the friar to know his remedy? If all else fails, myself have power to die. Oh, shut the door, and when thou hast done so, come weep with me. Past hope, past cure, past help.
Oh, Juliet, I already know thy grief. It strains me as the compass of my wits. I hear thou must, and nothing may prorogue it. On Thursday, next be married.
Don't tell me thou hast heard of this, unless thou tell me how may I prevent it. And if in that faith that wisdom is not wise, then call my resolution wise, and with this knife I will help it presently.
Hold on. I do spy a kind of hope that craves as desperate a solution as that is desperate, which we would avoid. And if thou darest, I'll give thee remedy.
Oh, bid me leap rather than marry Paris from off the battlements of yonder tower, and I will do it without fear to live an unstained wife to my true love.
Hold then, go home, be married, give consent to marry Paris. Tomorrow is Wednesday. Wednesday night, let not thy nurse lie with thee. Take thou this vial, being then in bed, and with the distilled liquor, drink thou off. No warmth, no breath, shall testify thou liest. Thou shalt continue 2 and 40 hours, and then be borne to that same ancient tomb for all the kindred of the capital's lie. And then thou shalt awake as from a pleasant sleep. Shall Romeo, by my letters, know our drift, and we shall watch thy wake, and he shall come hence. And this shall free thee from this present shame.
Oh, give me. Tell me not of fear.
Hold. Get you home, be strong and prosperous in this resolve. I'll send a friar with me. To Mantua with letters to Romeo.
Love, give me strength, and strength shall afford. Do well, dear father. Dear nurse, leave me to myself tonight.
Good night. Get thee to bed and rest, for thou hast need.
Farewell. God knows when we shall ever meet again. Come, vile. What if this mixture does not work at all? Shall I be married tomorrow morning? No. No, this shall forbid it. Lie thou there. What if it be poison that the friar has suddenly ministered, knowing that he shall be dishonored for marrying me to Romeo? What if while I'm lying in my tomb, I wake up before Romeo come to redeem me? There's a fearful point. Romeo, I come. This do I drink to thee.
Madam, Juliet, my child.
Oh. Nurse, come, nurse, I say. What noise is here?
Oh, lamentable day.
What is the matter?
She's dead! Deceased, she's dead! Alack the day!
Come now, is the bride ready?
to return. There she lies. Flower as she was, deflowered by him. Death is my son-in-law. Death is my heir. My daughter be upwedded.
Oh, woe! Oh, woeful, woeful, woeful day! Most lamentable day, most woeful day!
Black, my child's dead. My child, my joys are buried.
Peace, home, or shame. Confusion's cure lives not in these confusions. Heaven and yourself had part in this fair maid. And all the better it is for the maid.
All things that we ordained festival turn from their office to black funeral. Our instruments to melancholy bells, our wedding cheer to a sad burial feast, our psalm hymns to solemn dirges change. Our bridal flowers serve for a buried corpse, and all things change to contrary.
Everyone, prepare to follow this bare corpse unto her grave.
If I may trust the flattering truth of sleep, my dreams presage some joyful news at hand. Ah, me. How sweet is love itself possessed when but love's shadows are so rich in joy. News from Verona. How now, Balthazar? Dost thou bring me letters from the friar? How fair is my Juliet, for nothing can be ill if she be well.
Then she is well, and nothing can be ill.
Her body sleeps in Capel's monument, and her immortal part with angels lives. Oh, pardon me for bringing these ill news.
Is it even so? Oh, then I defy you, stars!
I do beseech you, sir, have patience. Your looks are pale and wild, and do import some misadventure.
Tush! Thou art deceived. Hast thou no letters to me from the friar?
No, my lord.
No matter. Get thee gone. I'll be with thee straight. Well, Juliet, tonight I will lie with thee. Let's see for means. What ho, apothecary!
Who calls so loud?
Come hither, man. I see that thou art poor. Hold there. Is 40 ducats. Let me have a dram of potion as will disperse itself through all the veins that the life-weary taker may fall dead.
You know such mortal drugs, but Mantua's law is death to any you that sells them.
Art thou so bare and full of wretchedness and fearest to die? Famine is in thy cheeks, the world affords no law to make thee rich. Then be not poor, but break it and take this.
My poverty, but not my will consents.
I pay thy poverty and not thy will.
Take this and put it in any liquid you will. And then drink it. And if you have the strength of 20 men, dispatch you straight.
There is thy gold. Buy food and get thyself some flesh. Come cordial and not poison. Go with me to Juliet's grave, for there must I use thee.
Who's in Francis? Brother! Friar! Ho!
This seems to be the voice of Friar John! Welcome from Mantua! What says Romeo? Or if his letter be right, give it to me.
Well, here is it, I was sick. Where the affectionate participant did reign. The sword is still upon the door, and went on before, so my journey to my own was stopped.
Who bear my letter then, to Romeo?
I'm afraid I couldn't bear the letter. Here it is.
Unhappy fortune!
by my holy order, the letter was of dear importance. And I fear the neglecting of it may do much danger. Friar John, get me an iron crow and bring it straight onto myself.
Faculty, brother.
Unhappy fortune! Within 3 hours' time, O fair Juliet, awake. Now must I to the monument alone. Poor living corpse, close to the dead man's tomb!
Give me the light. I charge thee by thy life. Whatever thou hearest or seest, stand all aloof. Do not interrupt me while I descend into this bed of death.
I'll be gone, sir. I'll not trouble you.
So shalt thou show me friendship. Take thou that. Live and be prosperous. And farewell, good fellow.
All the same. Hide me here about his looks, I fear, and his intents.
Thou detestable moth, thou womb of death. Thus I force thy rotten jaws to open, and in despite, I'll cram thee with more food. Oh, my love, my wife. Death that hath sucked the honey from thy breath hath had no power yet upon thy beauty. Shall I believe that inauspicious death is amorous? Oh, here will I have my everlasting rest, and shake the yoke of inauspicious stars from this world's weary flesh. Eyes, take your last look. Arms, take your last embrace. Here's to my love. Oh, true apothecary, thy drugs are quick. Thus, with a kiss, I die.
Here's one, a friend and one that knows you well.
Bless me upon you. What torch is yon that faintly lends his light to grubs and isle of skulls?
One that you love.
Who is it?
Romeo.
Romeo? Romeo! Oh, pale! Romeo! Romeo! The lady stirs.
Friar, where is my love? Where is my lord?
Juliet!
Juliet! Juliet!
Lady, I hear some noise. Come, come with me, for I fear the watch is come.
Go get thee, hence, for I will not away.
I dare no longer stay.
Hast thou there? Poison, I have seen be his timeless end. Oh, churl, drunk in all and left no friendly drop to help me after. Happily, some poison doth hang on his lips to help me die with a restorative. My lips are warm.
Be on, boy, which one?
Your noise, then I'll be brief. Oh, happy dagger, this is thy sheath, therefore rust, and let me die.
meant to sell off their keys on first without morning's rest.
What should it be that they so shriek abroad? Some people in the street cry Romeo, some Juliet, and some Paris, and all run with open outcry towards our monument.
What thing is this that falls in our ears?
Sovereign, here lies Romeo dead, and Juliet dead shortly thereafter.
Warm, and you killed. Sir, sees how this foul lord comes.
Oh heavens, look how my daughter bleeds.
See how the mob outrage of totally cleared his ample guineas.
I, greatest, able to do least.
And say at once not knowing this.
I will be brief. Romeo, their dead, was husband to that Juliet. And she, their dead, wife to that Romeo. Her stolen marriage day was Tybalt's doomsday. All was miscarried by my fault. Could my old life be sacrificed and punished unto the rigor of severest law?
We still need for a holy man. Where's Romeo's man? What can he say in this?
I brought my master news of Juliet's death, and then in haste he came from Mantua to this same place, to this same monument. This letter here early bid me give his father.
Give me the letter, I will look on it.
Thank you. You're welcome.
This letter doth make good for the Friar's ward, the course of love, the tying of her death. He comes his vault to die, in lie with Juliet. See what scores is laid upon your hate, that heaven find means to kill your joys with love. And I, from whom can give discourse to, have lost the embrace of kinsmen, are punished.
Her Romeo.